Hey crypto fans, my name is Garrett and welcome to Altcoin Radar. Today guys, we're gonna see if Dogecoin could potentially reach $10 or not. So guys, if you guys are brand new to the channel and you think you'll enjoy the content that I create, then as always guys, go ahead and make sure to subscribe to the channel and go ahead and give this video a thumbs up because it helps me out and why not, right? And also guys, feel free to follow me here on Twitter as well. I like to talk about altcoins, NFTs, and all the kind of good crypto stuff on a daily basis. So if you guys are into that sort of thing, you can follow me with the link in the video description down below this video. Other than that, guys, we're going to see if Dogecoin can reach $10, okay? Now, obviously, this isn't something that I think can obviously happen in the short term. Obviously, you guys, we've all seen Dogecoin. We've all seen how Dogecoin performs. And here's the thing about Dogecoin, okay? Dogecoin does not have a max supply, okay? So pretty much a new block is created pretty much every single minute. And with each block comes 10,000 new Dogecoins, okay? So pretty much every single minute, the supply of Dogecoin is, growing by 10,000 more Dogecoins. So it's going to continue to grow more and more and more and more and more and more and more for the life, for the entire life of, however long Dogecoin is around for. So it's going to continue to rise. But here's the thing about Dogecoin, okay, guys? The only way Dogecoin is going to rise is if, and I'm going to do an example here, okay? So this is the supply of Dogecoin, okay? Oh, sorry, I'll do it like this. This is the supply of Dogecoin, okay? Dogecoin, the supply of Dogecoin is continuing to rise, all right? The demand needs to continue to rise with it as well in order for prices to stay, relatively balanced, I guess you could say. But in order for it to, in order for the price to really rise up, the supply kind of needs to be more demand than there is supply. And right now, realistically, right now where things are right now, there's just not that much demand for it, to be honest with you. And that's because Dogecoin doesn't really have any utility. There's nothing wrong with the coin. It's great for what it is. It's great. It does serve a purpose. I mean, people can use it for transactions to transactions, and it is fast. But realistically, you guys, there's really no use case for it. So realistically, there's no reason for a bunch of other people to put their money into it. So it is a very high risk investment, honestly, in my personal opinion. So honestly, you guys, realistically here in the long term, I do think it could potentially maybe reach, a dollar, no problem. But honestly, when we're talking about $10 here, I mean, gosh, guys, for Dogecoin to reach levels of $10, I mean, we're talking about an astronomical amount of money that would have to be put into Dogecoin in order for this coin to, skyrocket up to heights of, $10 here, okay? So let me just go ahead and grab my calculator real quick, and let me show you this real quick. So let's say right now, for instance, okay, we're just going to say right now, let's say hypothetical here, let's say Dogecoin were to skyrocket to $10,000, okay? Or sorry, not $10,000, that'd be nuts, to $10, okay? So we take this current circulating supply, all right? So we got 132 billion tokens, 132 billion, right there, 1,000 million billion, yep, that's right. And we're gonna go ahead and multiply that by $10, you guys, okay? This is gonna be nuts. And that's gonna give us a 1, 2, 3, 4, that's going to give us a 1,000 million billion, it's gonna give us a $1.3 trillion Dogecoin, you guys. Now to put that in perspective, you guys, Bitcoin just hit $1 trillion for the first time in 2021, okay? So the likelihood of a coin like Dogecoin with no use case whatsoever other than a fast, peer-to-peer payment system and fast transactions, with no use case, there's no way. I do not truly believe, I'm being realistic here because we're dealing with our real money here. So you have to be realistic in this market, you guys. Realistically, I don't see Dogecoin reaching $10, and that's simply because, there's just the demand just isn't there. It's really not. It would take Elon Musk. I mean, it would take a lot of Elon Musk's money, and it would take a bunch of other people's money to be able to reach, those heights of prices, to be honest with you. And I realistically, out of all these other coins that have solid use cases and have been rising, I don't see that happening in the short term or midterm at all whatsoever. Obviously, you guys, if you look behind me, there's no magic ball and there's nothing behind me that shows that I might be a magician or anything like that of any kind of sorts. So I can't guarantee you anything and I can't say that this is for sure how it's going to go. Nobody really can because nobody is a magician. We're all just people and we're just giving our own opinions, honestly. And, to be brutally honest with you, I mean, If somebody tells you that Dogecoin can go to $10, they clearly haven't done their research, because I have done my research, and based on my research and based on realistic numbers and figures here, $10 is pretty much unrealistically possible. So, you know, honestly, I could honestly see it going to $1, definitely no problem. Maybe even $2 in the long term, maybe. But to say it's going to go to $10, I just don't believe it, guys. And the numbers are there. I mean, a $1.3 trillion Dogecoin, that's exactly what that would be if it went to $10. All right. Now let's see if it went to a dollar. Okay. Obviously, $1 times 132 billion. And that's the thing, you guys. It's not always going to be 132 billion. It's going to keep rising as more and more Dogecoin is added to the overall supply. It's going to continue to grow. And that's the thing. The demand has to grow with it, but I just don't see that happening in the long term. It's literally going to take Elon Musk to, you know, talk about it like crazy or something like that to really bring Dogecoin up to, you know, those types of levels. So, I mean, realistically, you guys, anything is possible. We live in, you know, we live in a crazy, crazy world, okay? I mean, we saw Dogecoin go from, I mean, as we can see here, you guys, we saw Dogecoin go from 0.002 cents, I mean, literally fractions of a penny, to almost 75 cents. So, I mean, when you got an asset like that, that makes, you know, gains like that out of the middle of nowhere, I guess, you know, in the realm of possibilities, I guess it definitely is possible technically, but I mean, you know, I'm a numbers guy, and if we look at the numbers and realistically, if we look at the numbers, you know, the likelihood of it happen, it is possible, but the likelihood of it happening is very slim, okay? That is the best way that I can put it, okay? Without sounding like a complete, you know, D-bag or anything like that, right? So it is possible, but the likelihood is very slim, okay? Overall, though, you guys, you know, we saw the numbers, and, you know, obviously, it can probably go to $1, maybe even possibly to $10, you know, I wouldn't invest into Dogecoin based off of it potentially going to $10 is basically what I'm saying, okay? And here's the other thing, too. Dogecoin is a very, very, it's a high-risk investment. It really is. And the reason why is simply because it doesn't have utility. It doesn't have utility. There's nothing you can really do with it other than, you know, hey, I'm going to send you Dogecoin as a form of payment. Here you go. And it's faster than Bitcoin, or it's pretty fast. And, you know, it does work very well. And that's literally the only use case that it had, that Dogecoin has going for it. So, you know, realistically, unless Dogecoin does something very big that really, you know, knocks the shoes off of, you know, people around the globe, I really don't see that happening long term here, you guys. And that's just the realistic, you know, that's the reality of it. So, but that pretty much does it for this video, you guys. So I'll go ahead and wrap this one up. But again, guys, before you guys leave, again, don't forget to follow me on Twitter here with the link in the video description down below. And also, guys, if you haven't already, go ahead and take a minute to subscribe to the channel so that you never miss a new crypto and altcoin video from me on a regular basis. And hey, guys, with that said, thanks again for watching, and I hope to see you guys in my future videos or chatting with me here on Twitter.